and did what we heard from the woman at the well. Come meet the man who told me all these things about me. And she shared it with him, and he came back and got. So that's what we want to be looking forward to. That's what we want to be praying for. That's what we want to be doing. Amen? And so hear this. It's just called Our Ordinary Lives, and it's 2 Corinthians 4, 5 through 13 from the Message. Remember, our message is not about ourselves. We're proclaiming Jesus Christ, the Master. All we are is messengers, errand runners for Jesus, for you. It started when God said, light up the darkness, and our lives filled up with light as we saw and understood God in the face of Christ, all bright and beautiful. If you only look to us, you might as well miss the brightness. We carry this precious message around in unadorned clay pots of our ordinary lives. That's to prevent anyone from confusing God's incomparable power with us. And it is that there's not much chance of that. We've been surrounded and battered by troubles, but we're not demoralized. We're not sure what to do, but we know that God knows what to do. We've been spiritually terrorized, but God hasn't left our side. We've been thrown down, but we haven't been broken. What they did to Jesus, they do to us. Trial and torture, mockery and murder. What Jesus did among them, he does in us. He lives. Our lives are at constant risk for Jesus' sake, which makes Jesus' life all the more evident in us. While we're going through the worst, you're getting in on the best. We're not keeping this quiet, not on your life. Just like the psalmist wrote, I believe it, so I said it. We say what we believe. And I ask that you would proclaim what you believe today through your worship, through your song, through your prayers, and even through the interactions that you would have through the rest of your day. So let's stand and proclaim what we believe. My eyes have seen the King of Glory. Oh, I'll never be the same. And now I live to tell this story. Jesus is the only way. Jesus is the only way. I'm gonna burn bright. I'm gonna let love rise. I'm gonna shine like stars in the heavens. I'm gonna burn bright. I've got just one life. Shadow that could hide it. And there's no place your love won't go. A light is breaking through the darkness. There's resurrection in my soul. Shine like stars in the heavens. I'm gonna burn bright. I've got just one life to shine like stars in the heavens. So here I am with open hands, my life laid down, surrendering. Here I am, oh Father, send me. Here I am with open hands, my life laid down, surrendering. Here I am, oh Father, send me. Here I am with open hands, my life laid down, surrendering. Here I am, oh Father, send me. I'm gonna burn bright. I'm gonna let love rise. I'm gonna shine like stars in the I've got just one life to shine like stars in the heavens. I'm gonna burn bright. I'm gonna let love rise. I'm gonna shine like stars in the heavens.
From death to life. You know you really want to sing this next part.
Haunted by the past no more, my innocence has been restored. Forgiveness flows from your veins, your kindness shown.
Times we'll say, hey, take a moment and remember what God has done, who he is to you. I testify the fact that we just ask people to say to God how good he is at this moment. He said we are already in the park worshiping. We've got to worship with, you know, 20 some other people that are not a part of our church, but they knew the Lord, and it was pretty obvious. But even when they took the moment to thank the Lord, I saw people crying. Why is that? Because God's so good. So just take that moment and thank him. Thank him for the goodness.
Maybe you've been praying for somebody. Remember, with Christ, all things are possible. With us, probably not so much, but keep praying. He's so good.
You are good.
God, you're so good, always good to me. So good, always good. Oh, your mercy never fails me, and all my days I've been held in your hands. The moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkest nights, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. I have lived in the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. Your goodness is running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after. It's running after me. Your goodness is running after. It's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now, give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. All my life you have been all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. The goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God.
Give myself away.
I give myself away so you can use me. Give myself away. Give myself away so you can use me.
I give myself away.
Not my own, to you I belong. I give myself to you. My life is not my own, to you I belong. I give
Passage that we read to start this whole thing off with. We do pour ourselves out because Christ was the example and poured himself out. And we can declare that we've decided to follow him in those ways, the hard ways, the easy ways, all of them. I have decided to follow Jesus.
I have decided to follow Jesus.
I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. Though none go with me, still I will follow.
Well, Father, indeed, may that be true of us, that we may follow you because we see your goodness, we see what you've done for us. And so would you give us a little confidence, Lord, to follow you wherever it is that you would lead us. Today and every day, we ask this in Jesus' name and offer you all the praise and glory. It's in his name we pray. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Well, you may be seated. You can clap again, too. I heard something. That's fine. Go ahead. Yes. or not. That's fine, too. As we come to our time of prayer this morning, we're going to do something a little bit different. In addition to what we normally do, but I'm going to invite a couple things to happen. One is that, as is our custom here at Hanfield, that if you have a particular need for prayer this morning, I'm going to invite you to just stand where you are, and then people can lay a hand on you or stretch a hand out towards you. And then the other thing I'm going to do as well is I'm going to invite, speaking of following where the Lord leads, I'm going to invite Steve and Andrea, if you wouldn't mind coming on forward. You can come down here. Steve, many of you know Steve. He's been with us here. Steve and Andrea have been with us for a couple years now since you retired, I thought. And he has recently unretired. He's been preaching at a church for a couple of weeks now, and is actually going to be going back a little bit more long term, and going to be there through the end of the year, filling in at a church. And so he is following where the Lord is leading him. And so I'm grateful for you, Steve. I'm selfishly, if I can admit it, I'm a little bit sad. For at least a few months, we won't see you here. I'm going to invite you, if you would. So if you have a particular need, you can stand on your own. Or if you would, I'd invite you to come forward, and we're going to lay hands on Steve and Andrea and pray and just send them out to be ministers of the gospel elsewhere in the world. Steve, I think, you know, again, Steve, for those of you who are, if you're just visiting, Steve had filled in with me when I was out for 6 weeks earlier this year, and I'm very grateful for that. Just have appreciated you and your support, and so if you would you I invite you to come? Would you come and lay hands on Steve and Andrea, and we'll pray and send them out. And again, if you have a need of your own that you'd like to stand for, and people can surround you in prayer, we can do that. Let's pray together. Well, Father, we thank you just for the goodness, your goodness that we've sung of. We thank you for your leading and guiding each one of us. We give you praise for the work that you're doing. We see you moving and active. We give you praise for even the things that Brad had mentioned earlier, people coming to Christ, Lord. That's what we have desired to see in our community. And so, Lord, since you've already worked, may we be so bold as to ask for more. Would you give us more, Lord? We sense you're working and moving in different ways throughout each week and in our lives, and we just ask for more. And in particular, Lord, I pray for more of your Holy Spirit to fill Steve and Andrea as they seek to minister and to serve. I thank you for the inspiration and the Spirit of Christ is so evident in him. And I thank you for the way he has ministered to me personally and to this church as a whole. And so I ask, Lord, that you would give him more of your Holy Spirit. I thank you for his willingness to follow. Even as we just sung, Steve is truly living that out, and we give you praise, Steve and Andrea both. And so I pray that you would fill them with your Holy Spirit for the task that you've so clearly called them to. And Lord, for those who are standing, I pray that you would fill each need, each situation, that you would work and move in a way that only you can. And Lord, I want to ask even for more than that. Whatever the situation is that has brought people to their feet, I pray that we would be able to see. Not only we would know you're working, but we would be able to see it. Even this week, I ask, Lord, you're so good to us. And so because of you, we have confidence. And we have confidence to pray the prayer that your son Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Amen. Okay. Well, this time we're in just a moment, we're going to pray over our tithes and offerings that have been collected or will be collected. And as we do that, I just want to take a minute to mention that if you would like, so as you know, and I'll say more in a second. Well, this morning we have the great privilege of being able to hear from Bill and Lydia Allshouse, as well as Pastor Tony. And they are is going to share in just a minute. We'll sing another song and so forth. But just so you weren't ready to come up here. But I just want to mention, as we're thinking about tithes and offerings, that if you would like to contribute to their ministry, I encourage you to give to them generously as well. You can do that. You can write a check to Hanfield, and we'll send them one hopefully big check, you know, later on. We can make sure that gets where it needs to go. So if you want to, you can just write a check to Hanfield and put, you know, All's House on the MMO line or whatever, you know, just to designate where you'd like that to go. But we're going to pray over the offering that has been given, and also we're going to pray over the children, who can now be dismissed to second half ministry. Miss Shirley is waiting in the back there, if you would like to make your way back to her. We're going to pray over the offering that has been given or will be given, and we're also going to pray over the children as they go. Father, we thank you for these gifts that you've entrusted to us. Financial gifts are one thing, but children are so precious in the sight of the Lord. And so we ask that you would bless both of them. You would bless our stewardship of the gifts that is these children, and also our stewardship of the resources that have been entrusted to our care. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Well, I'd ask that you just kind of keep in that prayerful mode there. Sometimes we have parts of our worship service, we don't do it very often here, but we'll repeat a certain line over and over. And sometimes it's a reading. But the reading I want you to repeat over and over through this song is, Jesus is Lord. That's the prayerful moment I want you to remain in today. Is to say, even if you don't know the rest of the song yet, as we learn a new song, I want you to think about the fact that Jesus is Lord. Over this moment, over this season, over this story, Jesus is Lord. Over my family, over my friendships, over my neighbor, Jesus is Lord. Over this body, over this mission, church he's building, Jesus is Lord. Over our city, over our nation, all generations, Jesus is Lord. And seated at the right hand of the Father, high and lifted up, there is no is Lord. Over all sickness, over our questions, no matter what happens, Jesus is Lord. Over all idols and opinions, over angel every demon, over sin and over death, he is Lord. Over all powers and dominions, principalities and kingdoms, in the flesh and in the spirit, he's Lord. Seated at the right hand of the Father, high and lifted up, there is no other. Holy, 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 worthy is the Lamb, now and forevermore. Jesus is Lord.
Jesus is Lord. With all of heaven bowing down, angels and elders crying out, why wait when we can sing it now? You are Lord over us.
Proclaim it right now.
With all of heaven bowing down, angels and elders crying out, why wait when we can sing it out? You are Lord over us. You are Lord over us. Seated at the right hand of the Father, high and lifted up, there is no other. Holy, 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 worthy is the Lamb, now and forevermore. Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord.
Amen. He is Lord indeed. I'm going to invite Bill and Lydia, or who, I don't know who all is. Oh no, just Bill and Pastor Tony. I'm getting the thumbs, not me. To come on forward. It is a privilege. Bill probably doesn't need much introduction for if you've been around Hanfield for quite a while. How long have we been supporting or it's been quite a while, longer than I've been here. But so it is just a privilege to have them here with us to share what's going on. We had the opportunity to hear from Bill and Lydia and Pastor Tony in Sunday school, and it was just a great to hear an update. So they're going to talk about that and exhort us to follow the Lord more closely, I think. So Bill, welcome.
It's a blessing and a privilege to be here again and to worship the Lord. How many of you have really sensed the outpouring of the Holy Spirit this morning? Amen? Amen. We are so excited to worship with you this morning and have a chance to be back in our fellowship, our armor bearers. And so that was pretty awesome too. And so thank you so much for that opportunity. Lydia and I had the privilege of traveling for 2 weeks now. Time goes fast. And we've been sharing in different places with different people about the exciting project that God has given us in raising up a Christian school where in a town of 750,000 people, there is none. And so it's exciting. And to be able to have Pastor Tony with us and his wife Lucy is a double blessing. So with that, I'm going to do my best to translate this morning. So all of you that are bilingual, you know, give me a little grace this morning as we talk about some things. Pastor is going to share what's on his heart.
Dios les bendiga esta mañana.
God bless you this morning.
Es una grande bendición poder estar aquí con ustedes.
It's a great blessing to be with you all this morning.
Este que es un día muy especial para nosotros, los hijos de Dios.
It's a great opportunity for the children of God.
Dice la Biblia, es el día que nos gozamos y nos alegramos en él.
And so this is the day that the Lord hath made. We should rejoice and be glad in it.
Y qué hermoso nuestro gozo que él hasta el día de hoy nos sigue dando libertad.
And so, up to this point, he has given us a joy and a liberty in him.
Y esta mañana damos gracias a Dios también por permitirnos compartir de lo que Dios está haciendo en nuestras vidas.
And so we just thank the Lord for the opportunity that he has given us to share what is going on in our lives.
Lo que Dios está haciendo en nuestro país, México.
And what God is doing in our country of Mexico.
Trayendo esta libertad cada día más a nuestras vidas.
Giving us more and more liberty each day.
Por eso damos gloria y honra a nuestro Padre Celestial.
And for that reason we give glory and honor to our God.
Porque Jesucristo vino a darnos vida.
And because Jesus Christ has given us life.
Y quiero compartir con ustedes.
I would like to share with you.
Un tema que Dios ha traído a mi mente y a mi corazón para ponerlo esta mañana con ustedes.
A theme and something that God has given me on my heart that I'd like to share with you.
Y yo quiero que conozcan y recuerden que el plan de Dios para nosotros.
You know, you understand and you understand that the plan of God
es nuestra restauración.
Is our restoration.
Esta mañana hemos cantado la verdad de nuestro Dios.
And so this morning we've sung of the truth of God.
Que Él sigue ofreciéndonos esta restauración.
And see, He continues to give us that restoration.
Porque estamos en este mundo.
Because we're here in this world.
Las situaciones que cada día enfrentamos.
And there's many situations that we are confronted with every day.
Hacen que venga una carga a nuestros hombros.
And so it becomes quite a burden on our shoulders.
Hace que presentamos en algún momento desánimo.
And so it can also cause us to be very discouraged.
Tristeza.
And sad.
Pero cuando recordamos.
And when we remember.
Que el propósito de Él, de nuestro Dios.
The purpose of God in our lives.
Es nuestra restauración.
Is our restoration.
Y restaurar es volver el gozo de nuestra salvación.
And to be restored is to return to the joy that is restored in us.
Podemos ver que hay una razón para seguir viviendo.
And so we understand that there is a reason for us to continue living.
Y esta razón es que Él nos ha prometido la vida eterna.
And so that reason is that God has promised us eternal life.
Pero ahora quiero decirte que hay un plan también que Satanás tiene alrededor.
But I also want to share with you that Satan has a plan around us as well.
Y hoy ese plan está en marcha para dañar nuestras vidas como hijos de Dios.
And so that plan is ongoing. It's going, and it's a plan to destroy and to hurt the children of God.
Y puedo ver en la escritura, en el libro de Esther.
And so you can see in the Bible, in the book of Esther,
Satanás actuando como Amán.
And so Satan was using Haman.
Un hombre que quería terminar con la vida de todos los hijos de Dios.
And his goal was to terminate all the sons and daughters of God.
Este hombre estaba enojado realmente con el pueblo de Dios.
He was mad and upset at the people of God.
Así que hoy también nosotros podemos ver que Satanás está enojado con nosotros como pueblo de Dios.
And so today we can see that Satan is very mad and upset at the people of God today.
Este hombre Amán quería que el rey diera la orden de matar a cada uno de los israelitas.
And so Haman went and asked to have an order for to be given that all the children of God would be killed.
Pero Dios tenía ahí un plan para su pueblo.
But God had a plan for his people.
A través de Mardoqueo.
And through Mordecai.
Y Esther.
And Esther.
Esther tenía miedo.
Esther was scared.
Porque a Aún su vida estaba en peligro.
And so there was much danger.
Satanás está trayendo ideas a nuestras vidas.
And Satan is putting ideas in our lives.
Satanás nos está ofreciendo pensamientos.
And he was offering thoughts
que nos genera miedo.
That would give and cause fear in people's lives.
De poder levantarnos.
That would raise them up.
En contra de estos pensamientos.
And against their own thoughts.
Porque en este mundo.
In this world.
Globalizado.
In the global world.
A través del respeto a los demás.
And with respect for others.
Se ha mezclado algo que creemos que estamos respetando, pero en realidad estamos participando de lo que Dios no le gusta.
And so, in other words, it's all mixed together now with what we think we're respecting, we're actually accepting.
Como pueblo de Dios.
And so, like the people of God,
tenemos que estar atentos.
We have to be very attentive and aware.
Para no cometer el error.
So we don't commit the same error.
De estar llamando bueno a lo que es malo.
To where we would say, this is good when it's really bad.
Porque esto es ese plan de destruirnos que Satanás tiene.
And see, this is the plan that Satan has to destroy us.
Confundirnos.
To confuse us.
Como puedo ver algunos de ustedes que están confundidos.
And so how sometimes people of God can be very confused.
Pero esto es lo que está llegando a nuestros hogares, confusión.
And it's coming to our different places, our homes and other places, this confusion.
Nuestros hijos,
our kids,
se les está metiendo en sus mentes y en sus corazones.
It's getting into their hearts and minds, this confusion.
Estos pensamientos que llegarán a destruirlos.
This confusion that comes to destroy us.
Si nosotros no hacemos algo.
If we don't do something about it.
Nuestros hijos están escuchando.
Our kids, our sons and daughters are hearing.
Que ya no es tan importante tener presente a Dios en nuestras vidas.
It's not that important to have God in your lives.
Que ahora es más importante.
It's more important.
Tener dinero.
To have money.
Posesiones.
Possessions.
Y que posiblemente orar una vez al mes.
Or maybe you should just pray once a month.
Pero nosotros sabemos.
But we as parents.
Que necesitamos a Dios en nuestras vidas.
We need to have God in our lives.
Porque si Dios no está en nuestras vidas.
Because if it's not in our lives.
La vida verdaderamente va a ser complicada.
Your life will become very complicated.
Nuestros hijos están siendo enseñados.
Our sons and daughters are getting a teaching.
A aceptar el pecado.
To accept accept sin.
Ver a personas que están cometiendo pecados.
And they see people that are committing sin.
Aún amigos.
Friends.
Familiares.
Family members.
Pero no podemos decirles nada.
But we can't really say much.
Porque el pensamiento de este siglo.
Because the thought of this time thought in today's world.
Es respetar.
The thought is to just respect everything.
Pero el apóstol Pablo nos dice que la paga del pecado es muerte.
But Paul says in his writings that the punishment of sin is death.
Entonces, si yo estoy viendo a mi amigo,
and so we're confronting an enemy.
Si yo estoy viendo a mi familia,
see, if I'm looking at my family,
si yo estoy viendo a las personas,
if I'm looking at other people
que están haciendo mal,
that aren't doing good things, they're doing bad things.
Por la palabra de Dios,
well, for the word of God,
sabemos que el pecado traerá muerte.
That with sin comes death.
Así que yo quiero que esta mañana,
and so I would like this morning,
todos podamos reflexionar,
that we can reflect,
si estamos entendiendo el propósito de Dios,
if we're really understanding the purpose of God.
De nosotros poder tener compasión y misericordia.
And that we would have patience or passion and mercy.
Y poder decirles la verdad.
And to be able to share the truth.
Poder mostrarles el camino de la vida.
And to be able to show them the way of life.
Y nosotros caminar en este camino de la vida.
And that we would be walking in the way of the Lord.
Así que, si vamos a respetar sus vidas.
Si vamos a, si, are we gonna, sorry about this. If we're gonna, it makes more sense in Spanish. See, if we're gonna respect people's lives.
Vamos a no ofenderles.
Well, at times we're going to offend them.
Vamos a verdaderamente amarles.
But we want to truly love them.
Diciéndoles.
And telling them.
Que tienen que cambiar de camino.
And you have to change your way of life.
Que lo malo siempre va a ser malo.
That what is bad is always going to be bad.
Y lo bueno siempre tiene que mostrarse con bondad.
And so we have to show what is good so we can show them what is the right way.
En mi país,
in my country,
por tener esta aceptación de lo malo como bueno,
we are accepting what is bad for good.
Estamos a punto de perder una generación.
We are about to lose a generation.
Y quiero mostrarte este video.
And we would like to show you this short video.
Y que a través de este video,
and through this video,
tú puedas ver,
you can see
qué importante,
how important,
es conocer,
to know,
el plan de Dios,
the plan of God,
nuestra restauración,
that is our restoration,
regresarnos al origen.
And so that is our origin. That's what we were made to have.
Cuando Dios quería todo lo bueno para nosotros.
When God made everything perfect for us in the beginning.
Porque él había creado todo bueno para nosotros.
So he created all things for our good.
Y si a través de este mensaje en el video.
And so through this message of the video.
Dios te pide a ti. Hablar a alguien.
He is asking you to ask to talk to someone
que está tomando este mensaje que verás en el video.
That did you understand what the message was of the video?
Y aunque como Esther tengas miedo.
No, don't be afraid.
Puedas hoy por amor a ti, a tu familia, a tus amigos.
And so for the love of God and for your friends and family,
decirles,
tell them
que Dios también quiere restaurar sus vidas.
That God wants to restore your lives.
Esto que vas a ver,
we're going to see this.
Es una ideología muy fuerte.
It's an ideology that you'll see very strong.
No solamente en mi país, en todo el mundo.
And it's not just in Mexico, but it's here and everywhere.
Pero por respeto o por no querer tener conflictos con nadie.
for respect or not to have any conflict with anyone.
Callaremos.
We be quiet.
O mostraremos la verdad.
Or do we be quiet or do we show them the truth?
Yo creo que diremos la verdad.
We need to show them the truth.
Porque amamos a nuestros hijos.
Because we love them. We love our sons and daughters.
Porque amamos a nuestros amigos.
And we love our friends.
Y amamos la creación.
And we love the creation of God.
Escucha este video.
Listen to this video.
Y levantemos la mano.
And raise your hand.
Diciéndoles a todos los que están a nuestro lado.
And to just be able to show everyone next to you.
Que Cristo es el camino, es la verdad y es la vida.
That Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. Amen. We'd like to show that.
Cuando inicié este proyecto, cuando empecé a predicar en la iglesia sobre esta ideología,
when I am preaching in the church about this idolatry,
empezaron a querer quitar del internet, de las redes sociales, mis predicaciones.
And so at that point, they would like to take away and cut out my internet
Empezaron a decir que iban a meterme a la cárcel.
And to say that, well, if you keep doing this, we'll put you in jail.
Porque yo no tenía por qué estar atacando este pensamiento.
Because I don't have to listen to the, and believe in what they are saying.
Que era una libertad para las personas.
There we have freedom for the people.
Mi familia, mis amigos.
And my friends and family.
Cualquier persona podía creer en esto.
Well, whatever person can believe in this.
Pero yo sabía y sé que esto va a traer muerte.
But we understand that this kind of belief is going to lead to death.
Yo no quiero un amigo muerto.
I don't want a friend dying.
Yo no quiero una, mi familia, mis hijos muertos.
I don't want my family and my sons and daughters dead.
Porque nosotros sabemos.
Because we know.
Que no solamente es la muerte física.
Because it's not just a physical death.
Es la muerte espiritual y la muerte emocional.
It's a death spiritually and emotionally.
Y es muy difícil tener a alguien con muerte emocional.
It's very difficult to deal with someone that is dead emotionally.
Hay una tristeza en los corazones.
There's a sadness in their hearts.
Hay una carga tan pesada en sus hombros que no quieren vivir.
And so there's a burden on their shoulders that they just don't want to live.
Que yo dije como Esther.
And just like in Esther.
Voy a ser valiente en decir la verdad.
And so I'm going to be valiant and say the truth and share the truth, just
y si
like Esther.
Tengo que estar en la cárcel.
I could be in jail.
Si tengo que ser eliminado de las redes sociales.
Or I could be cut off from all the network, social networks.
Aún si alguien atenta contra mi vida.
And somebody might even attempt to kill me.
Si el propósito de Dios es restaurar a estas personas.
But the purpose of God is to restore these people.
A las naciones.
And all the nations.
Yo voy a proclamar la verdad.
I am going to proclaim the truth.
Porque yo quiero ver a todos ustedes y a nuestros hijos.
And because I want to see all of you and our sons
restaurados,
restored,
regenerados,
regenerated,
y listos para la vida,
and ready for the life eternal,
y la vida eterna,
and the life eternal.
Así que, especialmente a los adolescentes y jóvenes que están esta mañana.
Especially the adolescents and the young people this morning.
Yo los invito.
I invite you.
A que puedan descubrir una vez más.
You can discover one more time.
¿Cuál es el propósito de Dios para tu vida?
What is your purpose in life that God has for you?
Cristo te ama.
God loves you. Christ loves you.
Y él tiene cosas hermosas para tu vida.
And he has some amazing things waiting for you, planned for your life.
Y él también quiere que tú ames a tus amigos.
He wants you to love your friends.
Y puedas traerlos a la verdad.
And bring them to the truth of Jesus.
Iglesia.
Church.
Oremos.
Pray.
Porque no todos tienen el valor.
Because not everyone is brave.
Muchos pastores en México.
Many pastors in Mexico.
Les han cerrado la boca.
They're not speaking out.
Porque da miedo.
Because they're scared.
Proclamar la verdad.
To proclaim the truth.
Pero es nuestra tarea anunciar.
That is our work to be done.
La vida que Cristo da.
That to announce that Christ lives.
Y recuerden.
And remember.
Dios los ha puesto como una luz.
And he has put like a light.
No para que que estén abajo de una mesa.
Not to be hidden underneath a table.
Sino para alumbrar a este mundo.
But to light up this world.
Dios les bendiga grandemente.
God bless you greatly.
Amo a su nación.
And love the mission.
Amo sus vidas.
And love your lives.
Los pastores.
The pastors.
Y el grupo de liderazgo.
The leadership in this church.
Que permite.
That you permit.
Que podamos.
That we can.
Nosotros tener esta oportunidad.
And that we would have this opportunity.
Porque México.
In Mexico.
Conoció a Cristo.
We have found Christ.
A través de sus misioneros enviados.
Through missionaries that have been sent to us.
Y gracias a Dios por ello.
And thank you for them.
Porque hoy somos una nación.
Because it's a nation.
Que empieza a conocer a Cristo.
That has begun to understand and know Christ.
Y Él hará grandes cosas con nuestra nación.
And He planned, and God plans to do great things with our nation.
Dios les bendiga.
God bless you all. Well, you've heard from Mexico. And there's a great need. And you've seen the school. And the vision that is there, and what we are called to do for the generations to come, the generations that could be lost and changed forever, when we have a purpose, and just as in Esther, for such a time as this, God has given us an opportunity that no one else can fill but you alone. Each one of us alone can fill that opportunity because we all have people in our lives that we influence. We may not be a huge leader, we may not be in charge of anything in particular, but as we live our lives, as we live and breathe, as we have Christ inside, we are influencing others. And so we just challenge all of us, us included, to be committed to what God has for us, to speak the truth in love and never back down, because God is with us. Who can be against us? Right? And so we're so thankful that if God has given us this opportunity to not hide the light underneath, but keep that light shining everywhere we go, without reservation, without apology, and knowing that that light brightens a dark world. Thank you all for the opportunity for us to be up here and share with you and reconnect. It's like a reunion for us that is a blessing, a huge blessing. Just quickly, the school is going, as the armor bearers know, because they're supporting one of the students. And so there's about 30 kids in one of our churches right now, but it's there's no more room. No more room in the inn. And so that is the purpose for building this school, not only for them, but also for all the other kids that would consider coming and being changed by knowing Christ as their Savior and learning a biblical worldview that they can take out into the world after they graduate and be change agents for the Lord and change agents for their society and furthering the kingdom of God. We have things on the table too if you're interested in supporting a child or are just giving towards that fund or also helping us with the construction. We're hoping to open the school by next fall. So it's gonna come really quick and we need done to this point, but there's more to be done. And there's a great goal ahead of us to be able to change. Change? No, I'm crying. Change children's lives forever. That can change their society, that we can look back. We don't have to look back anymore, but just keep looking forward and keep looking to Christ, being able to live in truth and live in love and make a difference in their world. So I'd like to, in closing, I'd like to just share a song with you. You know, kids are very honest and they respond very quickly to things and needs. And I want to share a little song about the fact that, you know, we give at times maybe less than we should. And I'm speaking to myself that maybe God was asking us to give towards something that he needed, he wanted our resources for. And we kind of calculate, well, if I do this, then I can give that. But you know, anytime we just give out of our heart, give out of love, give unashamedly and without reservation, being the generous people that we are and are called to be, God multiplies that even more.
He heard the preacher say, a single dime could free a hungry boy or girl with nothing to eat. So he pulled a dollar from the pocket of his jeans, and he asked his mama, how many would this feed? She just smiled, and when she told him 10, reach back in again. What if I give all I have? What would that give to my son? A gift like that would change the world. It would feed a multitude. He didn't close his eyes or turn away. I can see him standing tall. He saw the need, and I can hear him say, what if I give all? 3 birthday dollars would have bought a special toy. But he reminds me of another little boy who gave to Jesus a gift of fish and bread. I wonder if he said, what if I give all I have? What would that gift do? My child, a gift like that would feed the world. It would feed a multitude. He didn't close his eyes or turn away. I can see him standing tall. He saw the need, and I can hear him say, what if I give all? Long ago, a father and his son saw the children lost in sin. Can you see the tears in the father's eyes as Jesus says to him, Father, what if I give all? What would that gift do, Lord? Father, if I give everything I have? My son, a gift like that would save the world. It would free the multitudes. What if we give all we have? What would that give do? My son, a gift like that would free the world. It would free the multitudes. We cannot close our eyes or turn away when we hear the Spirit call. We see the need and I can hear Him say, what if I give all? What if we give all?
Well, thank you, Brother Bill. Thank you, Pastor Tony, as well, for exhorting us and challenging us to follow the Lord faithfully. I want to encourage you to go out, and they'll be out there at the table. They have information. I encourage you to talk to them. And as I said, you know, you can give generously through the Hanfield if you want. If you want to give directly, you can do that as well. One of the things I just wanted to mention that Bill and Lydia had shared in the ABF hour that I thought was very important, that gives just a sense of the scope of the mission that they're working with there in Irapuato, is I believe you said that there were about 750,000 people in the population there, and only about 6,500 Christians or evangelical Christians in that area. So that gives you kind of a scope of the mission and the opportunity and the mission that there is there, and the need for what they're doing. So. Would you stand and receive the benediction? As we depart this worship service, I leave you with these words. Now may the love of the Father, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the fellowship and sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest and abide on each and every one of you until Jesus comes or calls. Amen.